What does generic radio ID mean?
Just introduce the single.
Okay.
Not a particular station.
Hi, this is Colin from Radiohead, and here's our latest single.
Come on, there's more on there.
Is that right? Okay.
I'm not saying anything else.
Oh, sorry.
What? Is it SWH? You're going to go SWU.
No, it's pronounced S We Her.
What's that say?
Okay, all right. Hi, you're listening to. Hi, this is Radiohead, and you're listening to Radio S We Her. That's what it fucking says.
What country is it?
Latvia. S We Her.
Fine.
Just read it.
Leave me alone. It's not funny. Hi, this is Colin from Radiohead, and you're listening to Radio Mix FM 102.7. Hi, this is Ed from Radiohead, and you're listening to Radio Centris. Hi, this is Johnny from Radiohead, and you're listening to Radio Cax. I can't say that. It's Cax. That's Rack. That's what it says.
Yeah, well, just read it if it says that.
Hi, this is Colin from Radiohead, and you're listening to Radio Cuckoo. Hi, this is Colin from Radiohead, and you're listening to. Oh no, you gotta go through all these DJs.
Yeah, well, you do it. Just do it.
This is awful. I hate this. You do some now.
Look,
you're doing this one.
Yeah, absolutely. Hello, this is Ed from Radiohead, and you're listening to.
Particular reaction of your audience tomorrow in the concert?
I'm terrified.
Why?
Just because, you know, saying just coming back, it's sort of quite terrifying. And just going into the whole, the wheels start turning again, and the industry starts moving again. This time bigger, more terrifying, and it just keeps going, basically outside of our control.
So if we have to go back.
What? Lucky is actually wildly appropriate. Well, we're standing on the edge.
Why is it lucky?
Well, that's too lucky.
Love.
system have been toxic. Local Henry still cries a local film, still kisses its arm. No longer empty Atlantic, like a cat, characteristic. What's your warranty? Crazy implicit, real dirty, killer, and hopeless. Come, fully, properly,
album is going to be a classic.
Well, the album is called OK Computer, but there's no any song called OK Computer.
What is music to you?
What is music
to you?
To us.
So are you related to, in some way, to the Britpop scene?
Is there anything that you want to do that you haven't done?
Oh, Lord.
What did you wanted to achieve when you started the band? Was your aim?
How do you define the Ralph Wilson? Do you think there's more influence from Genesis or Uptown Floyd?
No.
We all hate progressive rock music.
Your record is, this record is incredible.
One might say a lunatic, crazy act of desperate men.
Not just a soundscape, a brand new dreamscape.
Dreamscape?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Personally, I had a sound in my head. The sound of big glass shopping malls. Lots of glass and chrome and white and stuff.
I think of it as a sort of, as a kind of mantra.
It's kind of white and shiny.
What is?
The record. It's kind of white and shiny.
I had a reason for it a couple of days ago, which is the best one yet, which was that OK Computer is about everything being out of control.
Thank you very much for coming to talk to us and ask questions.
So we can see the people, because we haven't seen them yet. Thank you. Hello. We'll be right back.
whatever you want. You're so fucking special. I wish I was special.
Thank you.
stage giving us shit.
I get on about 11
a.m. What? I look, I was sitting so off and out of your
shot. The guy that was working with me playing
all the way through as this.
Oh.
Playing loads of shit and like trying to play. What? Conversation on
the bus a few days ago. The five of us
talking about how it's the freakiest thing about all of this, like, you know, any of it at all, is the idea that you would be like one of those bands to somebody. I just remember like listening to Strange Ways, the Smiths, and this girl. I used to stay out in Oxford. She bought that album that came out and stuff. But at the same time, it was like R.E.M.'s Dead Letter Office and all that. That thing of it being imprinted on your heart, you know. It's like every note of it.
It's very strange.
So I think every time I meet someone who's like that age, who comes to one of our shows, it's a big deal for me. Because I can remember how much of a big deal it was. You know, I never met him at the time, but I know how much of a big deal it is because I've met him since, you know. Everything else is bullshit, you know. It's a reason to keep going. That in itself is the reason to keep going. The idea that you form the part of the most crucial part of someone's, you know, nasty, nasty teenage bit. If everything goes completely wrong.
yeah, just on the corner or whatever.
Can we get a receipt for that, please?
Heroes died. in subways left behind, far behind, like our love. You're on your own again, and you're your best again. That's what you tell yourself. I see it all the way, as far as anyone can see. Except when it began, I was so happy, I didn't feel like
remix pour Climbing Up the Walls, qui est aussi c'était enregistré avec notre ingénieur Nigel Godrix, qui a enregistré et aussi réalisé OK Computer, et il est à deux amis, Henry et Sam, qui aussi très talented. Bonjour, je suis Colin et vous écoutez... Enfin,
de Radiohead.
Bien sûr. Bonjour, je suis Colin de Radiohead et vous écoutez à WeFM sur 102.3. Merci.
Merci beaucoup, Colin.
Ça va?
Super. Très, très bien. Merci beaucoup.
Merci.
Merci.
Yeah, some of them are.
Yeah.
You can get a 97 Gibson guitar if you want to.
Yeah. Well, I don't want to. Then.
You don't have to.
I don't want to.
Okay. Sparkle Horse.
Sparkle Horse.
Last question. What is the stupidest question a journalist ever asked you during an interview?
There's a feeling. There's a. It's very interesting.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I'm very formal.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Right, on to another one.
Oh, let's go. Oh.
If we get the music across, then that's the most important thing.
if you can still make it intimate.
Thank you so much.
No, that's great. That's great. Thanks.
About Paranoid Android and some other songs of the album. Do you like all this science fiction stuff?
Hello.
Just to introduce a little bit, well, this is Gilbert, the head of our company.
Yes, hello.
This is Michelle, the head of the EMI label.
Hi.
Rodolphe and Guy, who are both co-head of sales. Sophie is the head of press. Tanya, I know you all know.
As I speak, we already passed double gold album. We're flying to platinum status. And it's well deserved, and again, we just enjoy working your music.
Well, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Everybody's gonna work.
So well done.
it's so cool.
Thank you.
you cut your wrist to?
You know, critics love Radiohead. I think they're all right, but it is a bit, you know...
It's the most miserable sounding tunes I've ever heard.
It's not the sort of stuff you want on your first birthday together, is it?
No, no, not really.
It's an interesting video, though, because that's Tom York there, and as you can see, look, it's filling up with water.
Oh, God.
And it actually goes the whole way. You'll probably quite enjoy it because he actually drowns at the end, so that'll probably like it. It's like, I think it's a reconstruction of Houdini's last stunt. But that's it, it just moves up. And then the song continues, and he gets completely covered in water.
Does he keep singing?
Well, no, this is what I was wondering. Look, it's getting very close to the mouth there.
Can we fast forward it a bit or something?
Look, he's now worried because the water's rising.
He's lifting his head up there, isn't he?
He is. You know, he's a bit nervy, but...
I can hear him, but I can't see his lips move.
No, he's... Oh. It's Roger de Courcy's son. There we go. He's under now. But he stays under there for ages. How he does it, I've no idea.
He hasn't said anything to me.
But you've told him that you need more light, right? And the whole conversation yesterday was we're going to start with their lights and...
Right, we're starting with our lights now. We need to come up a little bit.
Right, so when we try to come up...
I think we need to bring the level up a bit.
Well, but it's not just like that last thing. It's not just more light. It's like this guy's green.
Right.
It's color control. You know,
right, but is he...
When you're... I added light, but he's green.
Right.
And,
Right, so what... I'm just asking, what aren't you getting then? No cooperation? They're saying, no, that's not it. I like it like this. So just so that...
We're just not talking. They're not fighting it, but apparently the agreement yesterday was...
But are you asking for stuff?
Let us...
Are you asking for stuff we're not getting?
But are you asking for things?
No.
Well, maybe you should start
asking. You told me to...
Make it three.
Sorry.
All right, let me go talk to him. Let me go talk to him.
You ask him.
Okay.
You know.
Let me go talk to him.
Okay, I just thought this.
Okay, he's not being a prick, but he, well, we got
him. We just need to...
Radio stations, modern rock, it's such a stale format. As far as I can work out, and we can work out as a band, is that the music that they play on these stations is not for the people, it's to satisfy the advertisers. It's completely reactive in, as opposed to proactive.
There's a line in Karma Police about he buzzes like a fridge, and to me, sort of, after a while, if you had the, you know when you're driving around in America and you have the alternative stations on in the background or in your hotel room or whatever, and it's just like a fridge buzzing. It's not. That's all I'm hearing. I'm just hearing buzz. Mm-hmm. It's really odd. Mm-hmm. It's kind of funny though, really. I just have to laugh.
Well, the one song that you had that was obviously was really embraced.
Yeah, that had the fridge buzzing in it. Yeah.
Was the modern rock format. Yeah, was yeah. Creep. You know,
yeah. When yeah.
You guys first came in with that. That was like.
That's a good fridge buzz. If they're going to call it a concept record and they're going to focus on the technology thing, and it's like, well, just let them. It's fucking noise anyway. We've done our job. Mm. You know, let's just add to the noise. It'll be interesting to see.
Virgin Atlantic Airways, flight 90.
Well, we've just heard here on 95.8 Couple FM, up for Brit Success with a couple of nominations so far. Ed and Phil from Radiohead, welcome.
Thank you, Helen.
Shall I say, put that in a slightly different way?
10 minutes after 1 o'clock, and they are here. The upturned lorry on the M40 did absolutely nothing, but they got him.
It's pretty heavy. The choruses are quite extreme on this.
Let's have a listen. Many thanks again.
should have like come with someone who knew where this was.
Tower lobby floor.
Tower
lobby floor.
Tower lobby floor. Putting
on the No, thanks very much for the award. Thanks.
Bye.
Hey, okay, Claire,
should
we get a bit of radio?
Okay.
Okay.
Go
on.
Thank
you.
Don't you stand up,
sit down. Hey,
how are you?
I'm right, how are you? A bit of radio stuff from Radiohead.
Yeah. Hi, we're Radiohead and we're in Japan. And we'd like to say thank you very much to the readers who voted us and our album, best album of 1997. I fucked that up, all right.
It's fine.
That was
good.
No, it wasn't. I didn't even say the NME.
That's okay. That's fine.
No, it wasn't. Do it again. Okay. Thank you very much for voting us NME Best Album of 1997.
Cool.
Hi, this is Radiohead. Thank you very much. Hey, this is Tom of Radiohead. That's... Hey, this is Radiohead. We're on tour in Japan at the moment, so unfortunately we can't be with you in person. Thank you very much, Denmark, for the Grammy of Foreign Album of the Year. Hope to see you on soon. Hope to see you soon on tour. Bye. You do it.
Yes, this is all written down somewhere, isn't it? Let's think. Yes, we were at school, and yeah. Yeah, but I don't know, Oasis is having a good time and people enjoy their music, I don't know. Yeah, they make outrageous media comments, but the media enjoys them, and
I've had plenty like that.
Oh, no, I didn't know. They've been likewise, thank you. Bye-bye.
Amazing, he said halfway through, I can't do the accent, but, so does Tom York think life sucks? Oh, here we go.
Hello. Hello.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. I'm Ed.
Hello, I'm Colin.
We're from Radiohead, and you're watching TV. Wow, wow.
Good.
Good. Good.
Is it possible for them to take your number?
Number?
Three Polaroid shots.
Polaroids?
Yeah.
What kind of Polaroids?
short history of the 20th century. I mean, I'm not very good with all this stuff, but there is a point when countries, whatever country, almost happened in Mexico at the beginning of the year, because of the legacy of all the money that was lent to countries, developing countries, and then you have vast conglomerates using the labour of those countries. This is justified as the marketplace. This is justified as this is how the world economy works. This is how it works. This is how it should be. We take new countries on. We're loan sharks. You know, the West is a huge loan shark, and we're crippling these countries that could potentially develop and have to develop. We do it in such a way that we're basically extorting. The banking system is going to collapse.
No?
Yeah.
dinner ready?
It's the nature of if you make an album that's.
But that's what. That,
but I don't think that will actually change what we do, you know.
Of course, it changes your mental. It changes how. You know, a lot of things change, and we. It's just a head fuck. It's a complete head fuck. Isn't it? The way that we work is we always have a sense of bravado, and we all sort of say, you know, we decide to do something, and go, yeah, and we'll go and do it. And then we're halfway through and we just go, yeah. And we do.
Isn't it really to do with the excitement level's gone a bit?
Yeah.
Rather than sort of expectation.
I just feel that we should get out of the ghost. See, so, you know, if you're bored of the song, you're bored of the song. That's what you can do.
Check on breaking my new ones. Radiohead, welcome back to Australia. Just if you want to bring your chair up that side.
Do you feel like almost like a different band since that first tour?
I remember being on a plane all the time and feeling pretty low.
You going to perform at the Grammys?
Well, they said that we weren't good for the ratings.
Are you serious?
Yeah, yeah. It was cool. We were so happy, man. You wouldn't believe it.
When do you think you'll start work on the next album?
No idea. It's like a supply and demand thing. He's like, well, this is what they want me to do. This is what they want me to, you know, this is what they want to hear. So I'll do more of this, because this is great and they love me. And I can be the demise of so many recording artists, you know, because you suddenly people start giving you cash as well. Suddenly you've got money and you get used to this lifestyle and you don't want to take any risks because they got you by the balls. You don't want to take any risks. Like, why, you know, you've got all this baggage you're carrying around with you everywhere and you can't let go, you know, you've got all these things you've bought or you're attached to, you know, if you start getting money, you know, if you start spending all this money, you know, that's how they get you.
We're going away for 6 months after this tour because there's been too much about us in the press and we're slightly embarrassed about it in a very English fashion. And obviously there will be a backlash. If you believe the hype, you have to believe the backlash too. Any criticism we get is always stuff we've already criticised ourselves with anyway, Johnny insists. You read one bad review and 100 good ones and the bad one always seems to make more sense to you. Could that just say something about you, Johnny? I doubt it. Anyway, that's for you to decide. You're the journalist.
Ah, there he has me.
We've been actually working all day and the only thing we've got that's any good is the bass and guitar.
You're the worms, worms.
This is a song about believing you're actually wonderful when you know it's not true. Yeah. Here we go.
Hi, Tom. How are you doing?
Hi, all right.
Hi, Tom.
Shady.
How are you?
Good to see you.
Hi, Jen. It's me. 5, 4, 3.
Hey, it's Matt Pinfield. I'm back here with Tom York of Radiohead at Radio City Music Hall. Tom, the new song you're doing live called Big Ideas Don't Get Any. I love that title, by the way, too.
That's good, actually. I didn't have a title. I wanted to call it, I mean, I don't know what I'm going to call it. When you get a mortgage in Britain for your house, and all the adverts for mortgages and so on, they always have this thing at the bottom saying, if your home is at risk if you do not keep up repayments. I wanted to use that as the title. But I'm not sure if it's catchy enough.
I'm Matt Pinfield, and join me is Tom York from Radiohead, and we're at Radio City Music Hall. Tom, good to be back with you, man.
Hey, it's nice to see you again.
You know, always great to have you on the show. And, you know, it's been, I guess, almost a year now since we last got together on the air anyway, and we talked about OK Computer right around the time it was coming out.
Yeah.
It's been amazing response to the record since then. Obviously, critics' favorite. I mean, on everybody's best of the year list, and, you know, you get a lot of best band votes. How do you feel about that? How's it ride been over the last year?
You know, when it started up, it was great. Because we the first thing when we finished the album, we were convinced that the critics would panic because it wasn't, you know, and they didn't, and they did the exact opposite, which was really weird. And then
Well, we'll fuck that up.
That you choose.